CII is an organization which encourages women to participate in all aspects of their life. In fact, the secretariat of CII Telangana, the first chairperson of CII Telangana, Vanita Datla, very proud. I always, every session I attend, I always tell that, you know. And I'm sure with some people, more people sitting out here, very soon another woman will be on the CII chairperson. I look forward to that question. Could be anybody ready for that. So that's a great thing. Yeah, I'm not pointing out anything. I'm just saying somebody from here will for that. Now, India as a country is really becoming unstoppable. We read of so many things. 2025, we'll be the third largest, fifth largest economy. You know, all that is happening without a doubt. And the present Modi government is doing a lot of things in that direction. Now, there are some issues on that government. Some of the policies they have may not be acceptable, but at least on the economic front, a lot of efforts are being made to grow the company, the country economically, making it strong. Now, that can only happen when all sections of the society participate in a very, very positive way, including the women. A lot of progress has happened. Things are moving. More and more women are coming into the workforce, and definitely it will add to the growth of the country. No country which has a population of about 50% women can grow economically strong unless the women participate actively in that. And a lot of efforts are happening. But there are issues. And since I work for a company, I run a company on behalf of the shareholders, I'd like to share with you some of the problems that I face, and I look forward to some answers to those issues. I don't have the answers, I don't think many of us, but during the day I assume some answers will come out of it. And two of my colleagues are here, they learn from it and share with us for that. I'm very happy that both the colleagues are working with us for more than 20, 25 years. So that's not a small thing, you know. They got married, they had children, and still they continue to work without a major break. So that's the thing. Now, I work for a company called ITC. It has got various divisions, you know, cigarettes, tobacco, hotels. We have two members on the board of ITC. Now, the rule is there, but that's easy. To get a woman on the board is not all that difficult, you know. There are many of them. The problem is in the middle level. We also have a CEO of one of our IT companies who is a lady. So that's also good. The issue is in the middle management, you know. And I have a unit running in a place called Bhadrachalam. Many of you would have heard of this place called Bhadrachalam. I run paper industry there. A bit about paper. Morning I was talking to madam and she was saying paperless, you know, I'd like to travel. I may not be the right forum, but I thought I must share with you. Paper is good for the environment. Please use paper. Write some letters to your children, to your parents, read books. Because it's a wrong notion which is created that paper industry cuts trees. It does cut trees. But it also plants a lot of trees, you know. If we cut one tree, we plant three trees. So we make the country more green, more, you know, recyclable. Instead of using plastics, use more of paper. 35 years back, I wrote a lot of letters to my parents. My parents were in North. I joined Hyderabad, and I wrote a lot of letters to my parents. And they gave me all the letters, and those I still preserve those letters. I wrote letters to my wife. She still preserves it. 35 years, I don't know whether the computer will have any data to crash and all of that. So please use paper. It's good for environment, good for the country, and good for all for that. So I thought, you know, and everybody likes to get small notes of appreciation. Instead of writing the email, if you put a small note and say, I like your job, you've done a great job, that touches the heart of the people. So paper is good for everything, you know, good for the development of the country. So on that note, I'm very happy to see the men also smiling here, and the society is, always the growth can always happen with men and women together. So I have a unit called Bhadrachalam. We take a lot of fresh engineers and diploma holders, girls. We try to take as much as possible, 30%, 40%. We have created a bachelor's hostel there. And one of the floors we have made it for the girls. We have about 50, 60 girls. It's maybe a small amount. But 50, 60 girls is a good number to start with. So we got a thing there. It's a separate floor. The girls stay there. But we don't keep the girls segregated from the boys, you know. Ultimately, they all need to grow together, you know. So they are very happy, they feel comfortable, they love working there. But the issue is 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, everybody wants to get married, by and large. 95-96% get, 3-4% always are not sure about that. But what do I do? Because then the boy is somewhere else, in a place like Bhadrachalam, where do you provide jobs? In fact, I offered them, your future husband, get them to Bhadrachalam, I'll try and see where I can accommodate them. Once or twice we did that. The girl wanted to get married, said, my husband is looking for a job, can you help him? I said, I'll do everything possible to help him. So we got him, gave him a job. They're still there. We encourage the boys and girls to get married within the company. Now, it may sound a bit funny, but that's what we encourage, that, you know. We allow romance to flourish on the shop floors, as long as the work is not affected, you know. And few of them have got married. But the issue is beyond that. So after 4 years, 5 years, out of 20 girls I take, 3, 4, 5 I'm able to accommodate through this route. But what happens to the rest? I don't have answers to that. And I don't know, at the end of the session, with all the experience you people have, if you can find answers to this solution, how to give, in a city it's very easy. The boy will have a job in IT company, you know, and it's very easy. But all the jobs have to be created also in the rural areas. You just can't create IT jobs in the city of Hyderabad, Bangalore, and they expect the country to grow and develop. You got to create jobs in the rural areas, and that's how the economy will grow. Otherwise, you'll have the problem of cities getting flooded with people, infrastructure being banked. Look at what's happening to Hyderabad. It was such a beautiful place. Look at the traffic today. It's polluted. Issues of water, issues of roads getting flooded. And if we don't change this thing, if don't create jobs in the rural areas, the city will become unmanageable to live. What has happened to Delhi? There's no more a place to live. Ma'am, you must be staying in Delhi. You must be going through this experience. It's not a thing. Bangalore is becoming difficult. Hyderabad was a beautiful place. It's also becoming polluted. So these are the issues in the growth of an economy for that. And thought can always be addressed by all of us applying our mind together. And a conference like this will throw up ideas. You know, things are not going to change overnight. But I'm sure many more ideas will emerge from all of you. Share your experiences. Feel free to ask questions. Give your suggestions so that we as a country take it and make it a livable place. All of us are working together for what? For improving the quality of life of all of us, whether it is men, women, and children. You know, we want a better country, a better environment to live, where we feel happy, less tension for that. So I'm very happy that this full day session is there, and I look forward to all of you learning, sharing your experiences, and doing the one more thing. I must share my experience with you. We took a lot of girls, and all men are not saints. By and large, they are good, you know, but people are. One of the girls was teased by one of the workers. You know, he pulled her hand. It's nothing great. He pulled her hand, but even that is not acceptable. The girl complained, and we had to take a decision. What do we do? I said, if you just give me a warning, that won't be good enough. Sometimes you have to give a very, very strict punishment for a thing like that, so that message goes across. We decided to throw him out. I felt personally bad asking a person to throw him out. We decided to throw him out. The issue was, we had to convince the union leaders. And when I called the union leaders and I said, we're going to do that, to the shock of my life, he said, sir, it's okay. I said, why are you agreeing for a union leader to agree for a worker to be thrown out? You know what he said? Sir, my daughter is also working in Bangalore in some company. If this can happen with a girl here, it can happen with my daughter. So I will fully support you. This is all because the country has grown, his daughter has grown somewhere, she's working somewhere, and readily agreed to do that. So the country is changing, things are going to be good for the country, and I'm sure all of us will make it a better place to look for that. So have a good day, enjoy your conference, and look forward to a great learning for that. Yeah.